welcome to Salvation Center. This is iConnect News. My name is Chineze.
And I'm Busola. Here at Salvation Center, we have a vision of unity, whereby, empowered by the Holy Spirit, each and every one of us can come together and do great works here in San Antonio.
Yesterday, March 15th, was our food distribution day, as brought to you by the J Factor Food Program.
Along with food distribution, we also had healthcare professionals here doing health screenings. People also came along with fairly used items of clothing to donate.
To be honest, as Christians, we sometimes overlook the simple things that God has provided us with. We also tend to forget to take a step back and appreciate the resources He has blessed us with.
That's right, Chineze. You know, reading Matthew 25, verses 31 through 46 made me realize one of the reasons God has blessed us.
That is?
God wants us to be an extension of His blessings. And by doing so, we are exuding the qualities of Christ here on earth. So don't wait until Jesus returns to separate the sheep from the goats.
Of course, by that time, it will be too late. So now is the time to stop sitting and get involved. Tell the person sitting next to you to stop sitting and get involved.
Here at Salvation Center, empowered by the Holy Spirit, we have many ways to stay connected and get involved with the church. One of those ways is the J Factor, or the food distribution. So if you would like more information, please speak to Sister Wumi or any of the ushers.
Here are some highlights from yesterday.
Good morning, Salvation Center. I'm Victoria Yadi, and we're here at the food distribution that happens here at Salvation Center once a month. Let's go behind the scenes to see what actually goes on. Come on. As you can see, this is where it all comes together. And I'm here with Sister Wumi, who is the go-to person when it comes to all things J Factor and food distribution. So Sister Wumi, tell us, how exactly does this work?
Usually we have the food distribution once a month, the third Saturday of every month. And once people come on those programs, go to the sign-up table. Once they sign up, usually we have a list of the clients now that sign up. And then they are directed back here to get their food.
Good morning, Mary. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
Is this your first time attending food distribution?
Yes, it is.
And how did you hear about us?
Through Pastor Kay and Grace, actually. And I came for prayer one day, and Grace prayed for me. And ever since then, I came back.
So what advice would you give anyone, you know, attending the food distribution or being skeptical about attending it? What advice would you give them?
Not to be ashamed that we all go through trials and tribulations, and you know, this is the house of God, and He says come as you are, and He provides all our needs and even our wants.
We're here with our lovely pastor Adeko Isadi. Thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.
So just a couple of questions. What inspired Salvation Center to have the food distribution to start it?
Well, in the scriptures there's many examples of our Lord Jesus Christ preaching to people. And a number of times you see Him in scripture, after preaching, He fed the people. Jesus said, when I was in prison, you did not visit me. When I was hungry, you did not feed me. When I was thirsty, you did not give me to drink. We were inspired by scripture.
That's what we have here for you today. Back to you, Busola and Chineze.
A4C will be having a meeting on Sunday, March 23rd, immediately after service. We would like all singles and young adults to be in attendance.
Our 24-hour prayerathon service will be from 8 p.m. April 4th to 8 p.m. April 5th. Also, if you'd like to know more about our church membership classes that began today, please speak to any one of the ushers.
Remember to like us on Facebook and subscribe to us on YouTube. I'm Busola.
And I'm Chineze. Thank you so much for watching iConnect News, and we'll see you next week.
When it's a quarter past midnight and the gray skies fade to black, the waves splash and set me off track, so my vessel might crash or collapse. When I'm attacked and start wrestling in my head with these bad memories from my past, I'm aware.